السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah. And we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. May the peace and the blessings of Allah be upon him, ya Rabbil Alameen. The best of speech is the book of Allah. And the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who listen to the best of speech, the book of Allah, and follow its commandments. And may Allah make us amongst those who come to know the best of ways, the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and make us amongst his followers. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Ya Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-thumu shari'i, al-thumu qabi'i. يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة. يقول ربنا يا عبادي إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. Oppression is ugly. Oppression is evil. The Prophet peace be upon him taught us, and he said that those who oppress people in this life, they shall receive darkness in the hereafter. Or the path of oppression is one that only leads to darkness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He has proclaimed zulm, oppressing or wronging other people, to be haram upon Him. It is not befitting to His Majesty. And He proclaimed it that He has prohibited Himself from doing so, even though there is no authority over Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he said, I prohibit myself from being guilty of oppressing or wronging other people. And then Allah said, وَجَعَلْتُهُ بَيْنَكُمْ مُحَرَّمًا. And I declare it to be prohibited amongst you, between you, فَلَا تَظْلَمُوا. Do not oppress, do not wrong each other. Islam invites us to study history. And throughout the Quran, at least 20% of the Quran is history. The people of Nuh, the people of Ibrahim, the people of Lut, the people of Musa, the people of Isa, the people of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an invitation to study history. And you know, subhanAllah, in the philosophy of history, there are two schools. One school believes that history is linear, Meaning that there is one incident that happened 10 years ago, another incident 100 years ago. It's like one line. There is another school of history or philosophy that says, actually history is not linear. History is circular. People just keep repeating the same thing over and over again. You change the dates, you change the names, but humans remain to be humans, not learning from history. Keep repeating the same thing over and over again. So believers appreciate history. They recognize the importance of studying history. Because it is when we know history, we are able to make sense of what is going on and be in a better position to predict what might happen in the future at a human level. Speaking of which, you know, very soon Muslims will be celebrating and commemorating two events. On the one hand, we will be celebrating how the Israelites and Musa alayhi salam overcame Pharaoh and his people. And any oppressed soul, any liberated soul appreciates that story. You know, the story of Musa alayhi salam is the most repeated story in the Quran. It is the most repeated story in the Quran. And it all revolves around oppression, the psychology of the oppressed, and the psychology of the oppressors. Because Pharaoh, he is the embodiment. He represents oppressors throughout time. Arrogance, narcissism, cruelty, crudeness, you name it. Big army, person who is full of himself. And when you study all the pharaohs around the world, historically speaking, they are all the same. Because the Quran tells us that history is circular. And all the cronies around him, the yes sir people, people who are spineless, they don't stand up for the oppressed. People who benefit from the existence of the pharaohs and they don't say anything because it helps them. Historically speaking, these people will always exist. Religious scholars that would speak on behalf of the oppressor, not the oppressed, to legitimize the oppression that's taking place. So believers are aware of this. And then we're also aware of the psychology of the oppressed. Because when people are oppressed, it does something to their psyche, subhanAllah. So the Quran does not only tell us about Pharaoh, it does not only tell us about Musa, but it also tells us about the people who are oppressed. Because amongst the people who are oppressed, you also get to learn the different psyches. Those who are just comfortable where they are. You know, a beautiful woman, Harriet Tubman, in American history, she was credited by freeing over 150 slaves. She would sneak to the South, help them escape slavery and go to the North. So somebody said, Miss Tubman said, you did good. You freed over 150 people out of slavery. She looked at him and she said, I could have freed a lot more, only if I was able to convince them that they were slaves. That's beautiful. That's key. So the Quran tells us, what is it like to be oppressed and what it is like to be the oppressors? And beautiful story. You know, out of the messengers of Allah, the most mentioned personality by name is Fir'aun. The most mentioned personality in the Quran, out of the prophets of Allah, is Fir'aun. 73 times in the Quran mentioned. In 72 different chapters, 72 different surahs, Allah tells us about Fir'aun. There is a reason for that. So on the one hand, we celebrate. Because eventually, oppressors shall be defeated. And the oppressed will overcome when they do the right thing. When they do the right thing, they will overcome. And similarly also, Muslims will be commemorating one of the ugliest chapters in the history of Islam and Muslims. And brothers, please remember, the history of Muslims is not all beautiful. That would be a big mistake. لِذَلِكَ قَالُوا الْعِصْمَةُ لِلْوَحْيِ وَلَيْسَ فِي التَّارِيخِ.
التاريخ منه ما هو جميل ومنه ما هو قبيح. So when we look into history as Muslims, we completely understand that history is not infallible. Only revelation is infallible. But history is not. Our job is not to unconditionally defend history. That is sin. That is childish. Learn history and get to know what happened. So unfortunately, also on the day of Ashura, the 10th of Muharram, we get to commemorate and reflect upon one of the ugliest chapters in the history of Muslims. The killing of Al-Husayn alayhi salam, the grandson of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where the man is killed with his supporters in Karbala in the ugliest of ways. The head of his head was decapitated. We're talking about the grandchild of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is very telling. What in the world is going on? And the point when you study these things is not to point fingers. That would be a very childish way of studying history. But we want to understand, man, what is going on? Because it's this relationship of the oppressed and the oppressors. Because Al-Husayn alayhi salam, he gets up to stand against oppression. And you know the sad part about this, subhanAllah, is that people have reduced the life of Al-Husayn alayhi salam. By the way, don't be offended by Al-Husayn alayhi salam. Al-Bukhari, Al-Tabari, Kutab al-Sira, إذا قالوا علي عليه السلام, فاطمة عليه السلام, الحسين عليه السلام, عند أهل السنة يقولون عن أهل البيت صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه, يقولون عنهم عليه السلام, قالت العترة المطهرة عليه السلام كما يقول الشوكاني. فعبارة عليه السلام لا تتحسس منه. Okay. ليش؟ أنه كل من كثر علمه قل إنكاره, ومن عرف الخلافة اتسع صدره. So anyway, so what happens now is the life of Al-Husayn alayhi salam is just reduced to the last 10 days of his life. But what happened before? That's the only part that we are interested in. But of course, we want to make this relevant. You know, it's becoming so numbing nowadays that seeing black people, by virtue of being black, recipients of police brutality. And it's mind-boggling, subhanAllah. You see what is going on. You see the man walking away, police officers, big grown men who can de-escalate, but they choose to shoot the man, Mr. Blake. And I know that we all, in the Muslim community, we got excited when his father recited Al-Fatiha on CNN. It's like everybody is excited now. See, if you are only interested in the oppressed when they are Muslims, wallahi, I tell you, you are part of the problem. Wallahi, you are part of the problem. When you only pay attention to the oppressed only when they are Muslims, you are part of the problem. Because one day, you will be the oppressed and people will not be paying attention to you. The man wakes up, Sir Blake, and his father is talking to him. Do you know what was the first question that he asked his dad? He said, Dad, why did they shoot me so many times? Why did they shoot me so many times? 7 times right in the back. Why did they do that? So part of why you study history is that you must make a stand. Father Desmond Tutu from South Africa made some beautiful remarks when he said, in a situation of injustice, if you decide to be neutral, you have chosen the side of the oppressor. In a situation of injustice, if you decide to be neutral, you have chosen the side of the oppressor. Dr. King would say that silence is complacency. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, As-sabitu an al-haqq shaytan al-akhras. He who sees the wrong and doesn't say anything about it is nothing but a mute devil. A
But see, sometimes devils speak, and sometimes devils, they remain quiet. And we have a devil out of here. When it suits him, he speaks. And when it suits him, he's quiet. These are the worst types of devils. And that's why in the Hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, خَيْرُ أُمَرَائِكُمْ مَنْ تُحِبُّونَهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَكُمْ. He said, the best of your leaders are those whom you love and they love you back. And the worst type of leaders are the ones that they hate you and you despise them. And when you are that devil that speaks when it suits you, and you are mute when it suits you, Allah, you are nothing but a consistent, constant devil. الله سبحانه وتعالى increases in understanding our
world.
أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثاره المكتفى. My brothers, when you think of oppression, please do not only think in political terms. Do not think only in terms of police brutality. That is the most obvious. That is very explicit. There are many ways that we ourselves, we are pharaohs. Domestic violence. Brothers who beat on their women. People who abuse their kids. People who are truly a pharaoh in their own household. We be critical when we see other people wronging people, but we ourselves were guilty of that. Brother's watching the news with his wife when he saw a Zionist thug with the butt of his rifle beating on the head of an old Palestinian woman. Brother moves to peace and he starts crying. His wife starts laughing. Very offended, he looks at her and says, "You find this funny? You find this funny?" She said, "I don't find it funny. But I just remember that last week I was in the ER because you kicked me so hard you broke my rib. Today you look at it and this makes you cry. But at the same time, last week you just did this to me." So many times we can be reading about Pharaoh, but the reality of it is we are reading about ourselves. The Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ya Aba Dharr, كفى بك عيبا أن تجد على الناس ما تعلمه من نفسك." أبو ذر صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Abu Dharr, it suffices to label you as a sinner that you be mad at people for that which you yourself you are guilty of." So that suffices to label you as a sinner. So a believer does not accept oppression, stand up against it. A believer cannot be the oppressor. So we've got to start making sure that in our own circle that we are not the pharaohs. You cannot be the pharaoh at home, man. It does not make you, you know, more of a man. Allah, it makes you less of a man. You know, the idea of hitting somebody who's weaker or exploiting somebody who's weaker, man, that really may make you feel good. But it really makes you less of a man. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us facilitators of peace and justice.
Amen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who proudly stand up for the oppressed and they stand up against the oppressors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the courage to speak the truth whenever possible, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from being the oppressed or the oppressors, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all the people who are under oppression, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Given the circumstances of what is going on, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the people of Houston, the people of Texas, and the people of Louisiana safe, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the people of Karachi safe, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Great floods are taking part around the world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all the poor and the needy and everybody safe on each path, Ya Rabbil Alameen. If any of our loved ones is not feeling well, may Allah grant them a speedy recovery.
Amen.
If any of our loved ones has passed away, may Allah bless their souls.
Amen.
If any of us or our loved ones are going through difficult times, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our pain. May Allah protect us and protect our family. ربنا لا تكلنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله كثيرا واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم وذكروا الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. الله أكبر،
الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
After the salam, we start moving out of the back of the masjid to people who are in front. Please just stay back in. Still with the ring. Allah. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
faithful.